Hello everyone, welcome to Under Visit. The horror movies that critics loved are often overlooked by general audiences and may in fact receive poor reviews. The 2000s further had this divide as the horror landscape moved away from the late 90s slasher surge into more experimental undertakings. So there are 5 horror movies from the 2000s that critics loved. 1408. As we saw with Paranormal Activity, different people expect different things from their ghost stories, and some people didn't like 1408's approach. Despite making a solid $132 million, 1408 received a middling response from general audiences. Judging by the 61% Rotten Tomatoes audience score and disappointing VCinema score, critics liked the movie relied on psychological tension instead of gore or cliché ghost scares, resulting in a solid 80% on Rotten Tomatoes and 64 Metascore. 1408. Drag Me to Hell was written and directed by Sam Raimi, and it served as his return to horror following the Spider-Man trilogy. Critics adored this film when it premiered at Cannes, calling it a frightening, hilarious, delightfully campy thrill ride. The acclaim resulted in an excellent 92% Rotten Tomatoes score and 83 Metascore. But judging by the movie's middling 6.5 out of 10 IMDb rating, VCinema score and 62% audience rating on Rotten Tomatoes, it's clear that general audiences didn't take too kindly to Raimi's slapstickal departure. Lake Mungo. Lake Mungo is a little-known ghost movie that takes its bare-bones concept and runs with it in wildly imaginative and creative directions. The critics who have seen the movie agree that it is great, resulting in a very strong rating of 94% on Rotten Tomatoes. However, the audience score is a far more disappointing 63%, and the IMDb rating sits at a meager 6.2 out of 10. Generally, audiences really don't like ghost stories. Paranormal Activity. Paranormal Activity was the Blair Witch Project all over again. This is to say critically adored but largely divisive within the general movie-going population. This low-budget classic was well received by critics and sits at 83% on Rotten Tomatoes. However, the movie also sits at just 6.3 out of 10 on IMDb and has a Rotten Tomatoes audience rating of 57%, indicating that some people really didn't like the movie's minimalist style. Slither. Slither is another cult classic that came and went without much fanfare. James Gunn's B-movie homage was instantly acclaimed by critics, resulting in an 86% on Rotten Tomatoes and 69 Metascore. However, general reception was a bit more lukewarm, judging by the movie's B-cinema score and 63% audience scores on Rotten Tomatoes. It was also a box office bomb, making just $12 million on a $15 million budget.